Hello and welcome to a World War II game that actually features sunlight. Yeah, I know, I'm already thinking it's gotta be Game of the Year, at least get a nomination, because what? A World War II shooter that isn't running around a dark and gloomy European country? That's already impressive, as sad as it sounds. So to put it to you bluntly, I played this game because you get to shoot people in the face while basking in the desert sun. Not even gonna lie to you. Meet the main character, whose name I don't remember, which probably tells you everything you need to know about him, but he's just one of those Aldo Rain types, you know, he just focuses on one thing and one thing only.
Killing Nazis.
He's generic, but at least he's not annoying. And to top it all off, his German is really American, if that makes sense. For example,
the Germans are using Nebelwerfers. I have to do something about them.
You see that? Nebelwerfer? Yeah, that's the most American way to say German words, because it's clearly the Nebelwerfer, because it werfs the Nebel, much like the Flammenwerfer, it werfs the Flammen, und der Panzerschreck schrecks der Panzer, verstanden Sie? I don't know what I just said, but rest assured that the German in this game is very authentic. I would know because I passed third period German with an A-. Not bragging, but you know, it happened. Now getting down to brass tacks, the entire focus of the game is this cinematic right here. Sure, there are other features in the game, but they all support you being able to snipe people and view in excruciating detail exactly how they died. These are easily triggered if you get a headshot, yet they still happen if you hit people elsewhere, like you can get liver shots and lung shots, intestine shots, heart shots, kidney shots, and even the downright distasteful testicle shot.
Whoa, that's like fucking mean.
Personally, I have a different technique which involves ankle shots because from a strategic standpoint, wounding enemies is more burdensome on armies than killing them, but in reality, I just find the animation hilarious because it makes shooting someone in the foot look like a really big deal. Now in Sniper Elite 3, every level is different, yet every level is the same. You waltz through the desert to collect something, kill something, or blow something up. In the process, you're largely given free rein as to how you complete these missions, whether using your trusty well-rod pistol to be a silent assassin that ghosts through everything, or whether you're a 12-year-old that ignores all rules and decides to quickscope everything. Now, if you do take the stealth route, just know that enemies basically have three levels of alertness. Level one is they have no idea where you are. Absolutely no idea that you even exist. Yellow circle level two is they know all right, there's probably somebody around here. Yeah, I can't see him, but he's probably around here. And the red circle level three is, yo, that dude is like right there. No, I'm not talking he's like kind. No, he's right there, bro. He's right there. So when it comes to being stealthy, I have a personal rule that I call the Wir haben rule. Basically, if you come across a German and he's about to spot you, don't let him finish his sentence. For example, see that? He got to Wir haben and then he got blasted away and I'm home free. But if you goof it up and you let him finish his sentence like Wir haben Kartoffeln zum Frühstück, you're gonna be the one that gets blasted because you've just been spotted. You can also stab people, just a quick FYI if you don't want to make any noise while you're tiptoeing through the desert tulips. And when it comes to your loadout, really all you need is one of the sniper rifles, doesn't matter which one, the well rod, also known as your super silent stealth gun, and packing some explosives is usually a safe bet. Dynamite, dynamite. One thing I would add is that you don't necessarily need to bring everything with you, because much like any modern shooter, most of your enemies like to stand next to red barrels or explosives for some reason. But the stupidity doesn't stop there, because the officers are even worse. Like, look at this clown using his binoculars!
Benutze Fernglas.
This guy is arguably worse. Like, what are...
Attenzione!
The higher difficulties don't really change much, apart from enemies being more sensitive to your presence and bullet ballistics getting more and more realistic. But believe me, once you get good with the sniper rifle, it's so easy just to get in a rhythm of non-stop headshots, it's not even funny. And there definitely are some sequences that are just that, shooting dozens of guys from a stationary position while trying to skip the cinematic over and over again. It's straight up scope, shoot, skip cinematic, scope, shoot, skip cinematic. But believe me, you won't get tired of these cinematics until about 3 hours in, because with each one, I tried to imagine what the enemies were thinking as they got sniped.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
And that's about it. This is undoubtedly my favorite World War II game, even though I hate World War II. Okay, fine. All right, fine. I know you want to see one more, so I guess I'll show you one more.